I'm John Quarterman. I live up in the north end of the county and friends with me since the school district. And my mother was a school teacher in High Grove High School for some time, somewhere. And she used to say, "It takes a big man to admit it when he's wrong." And Fred Weatherington is a big man because he thought it was a good idea. He looked at evidence, he looked at the research and determined it was not a good idea. I look forward to members of QE standing up and being big men and women because the research, their own research, and the research that we heard tonight, and the research from Tennessee, and the research from Trigg County indicates consolidation is not a good idea. And one reason that it's not a good idea is, as we heard tonight, if it happens, which I hope it doesn't, taxes for people in the county will go up, and a lot of people in the city too, but particularly the people in the county who do not get to vote, and outside of Valdosta, who do not get to vote on the referendum. Is that not taxation without representation? That's my question.
Mr. Quarterman, in my opinion, it is. I've used that analogy before.
I'd like to commend the Lowndes County Board of Education and the city superintendent, for inviting, having this forum tonight, as well as I'd like to thank all of the individuals who have come out to actually hear what's going on instead of listening to hearsay. But my question is in regards to consolidation, and this question hadn't come up. I just thought it was a good time for, since we have both boards together here tonight, to ask this question. And the attorneys here, and I'm proud to see your attorney here, Mr. Chairman. Consolidation passes. We continue to hear the word diverse. As we stand now, both systems have board, and as Mr. Turner said, Turner stated that once the vote has been validated, the citizen system board no longer exists. This would have to be redrawn. Has the board, the superintendent, board, and the attorney had any thoughts on that? And if so, can you elaborate on how that might be done?
No, I can't elaborate on it because we haven't had any real conversations. We've talked to attorneys who have worked with other school systems. See, there are very few school systems who have consolidated. There's only one school system that's consolidated since 93, and that's the Sumter County American School System. And generally, when school systems are consolidated, you have the city school system wants to give up their charter, so it's not real controversial. Here is an unusual situation. You've got the city school system who chooses not to give up their charter, the county school system that supports their effort in not giving up their charter, and you've got a litany of organizations, recognized organizations that are opposing it. You've got two organizations over here that are for it. Quite frankly, I'm not sure why we've gotten to this particular point in time, but to answer your question, I can't answer at this particular point in time. Should consolidation occur, the process will begin on November the 9th. I don't think consolidation will occur, and I hope that we don't have to begin that process on November the 9th. But should it occur, November the 9th, and it would be done by the Lowndes County Board of Education working in conjunction with the previous Valdosta City School System. It could take days, it could take weeks, months, years. You just don't know. Warren.
Thank you, sir.
Warren, and I know Warren Lee, and I'm Warren Turner. I like your name, my friend. One of the things I do want to clarify, when I said that the school system ceases to exist, at the time that the Secretary of State approves the vote of the electorate, then the Lowndes County School System Board, the only existing duly elected board, makes a determination unilaterally when they have made accommodations and arrangements to take over the operations of the city school system. Now, that does not mean that if the Secretary of State acts on the 10th, that there's immediate chaos. Y'all can still teach the children in the city school system, but the Lowndes County Board has an obligation to notify the entity when it's in the position to take that over. And from the information that I've seen in reading the law, it would not be in the best interest of any fiscal agent to allow that town to be drawn out. So it would need to be an orderly assumption of those duties, and it would need to be a relatively quick assumption of those duties, whether it's a day or a week or 10 days. But QE has stated that we're to work together. I'll get the code section because I welcome any of you to pull it up and look at it. It's OCGA, which is Official Code of Georgia Annotated, 20-2-371.
You
said it again. 20-2-371. And when the Lowndes County Board has arranged for the takeover of the former Valdosta City School System, they notify them. And that, again, is the implementation of the statute. It'll be done, I would assume, relatively quickly, but that's going to be up to the vote of the board members on the Lowndes County School Board at that time.
But the district, board district will have to be redrawn.
Board districts will be redrawn, and that can be done a variety of different methods. It can be seeking approval from the Justice Department, placing it on the ballot in the next available electoral period. It can be the Lowndes County Board could appoint a couple of people as non-voting board members. Anything that the federal government, the Justice Department allows us to do that we request to be done, again, is not our determination from that standpoint. It's what they allow us to do from Washington. And it takes it away from